Not a headache again.
For brushes yesterday.
Hey there.
Milk,
show me what you. Don't know that I'm gonna buy anything, but I sure wouldn't mind a few rounds of Gwent.
Run, Roach.
Come on!
expecting, eh? Now closer.
We know each other?
Not personal, like, though I've seen ye many times. I've a gift. I see the future. Yours as well.
But not for free, I guess.
I don't ask much. If you've a bite to eat.
Here.
Thank ye. A fine offering. Well worth a foretelling.
All right. Let's hear it.
I see a white wolf. He looks on as the great viper bites and devours the silver lily. He wants to spring. He wants to fight. But the serpent is quicker. The lily must perish.
That's not the future. Lived through that, and you probably heard about it in some ballad.
My third eye grows foggier the older I become. But if you bought me some dragon's root...
Rare plant.
Rare indeed. But it did once grow in a cave southeast of here.
Fine. I'll see what I can do.
Ooh, you're back.
Wanted to ask...
I play Gwent. And I, we can play for the prize card in my collection.
You a mind reader?
The good gods did bless me with some precognition. I say some, because it's selective-like. Only applies to mundane matters. Not a bird'll ever shit on me, but all my foresights never helped me win at Gwent.
Let's lay 'em out.
The soothsayer's lot. I know where to find the finest slippery jacks this fall, but how to play and not lose, that I'll never know. A beautiful win. Take this card. You deserve it.
Know of any others who play Gwent?
You've but one opponent worth your while in Velen, in the village of Midcops. They calls him Haddy. He's a tyke. Barely a handful of summers to him, but don't let that fool ye.
Thank you.
black Temeria is now Temeria at all.
You going north, Master?
Why do you ask?
I thought you could see if anything's happened to our men. They've been gone a while.
My reward. How do you want to figure it?
Oh, we thought... You're owed for your trouble. Dunno. Could you drop it a bit more? If that suits you, excellent.
What do you need?
Merchant caravan came through not long past. Hired some of our boys to guide him to the bridge. They were due back yesterday.
Fine. Keep my eyes open.
Me brother Tomil led him. Talk to him when you find them. Clever man. Not like the rest of them, eh?
Chains?
Wouldn't mind a drink. Show me what you got. Thanks. Farewell.
Where'd you come from?
Long live Radovid!
Move on.
Dwarven moonshine. Nothing stinks quite like it. There's the bottle. Muggs was attacked here. Looks like rain. Hand over the documents, thief.
Me? A thief? I won him straight, I did, in a game of cards.
Not how Muggs sees it. Claims he was... mugged.
We lost. Demanded them papers back, and when I refused, he walloped me over the noggin with a bottle. Barely escaped with me life.
How much are they worth to you?
Well, I don't read myself, but I've seen the seals. I know it ain't no scrap of arsewine. I won't sell them to the first fella comes asking.
Listen, it's like this. Either give me the papers, or I'll take them from you.
You think I'd frighten that easy?
Stop! You fucking bang.
Enough.
Enough! I'll give you the damn papers. Take them!
Found the thief who took your documents.
I can't. Let's go get him. You can hold him while I take what's mine.
Slow down. See, this man said he never attacked you. Said you lost to him at cards.
Ach, cheeky bastard. Well, like me Aunt Rosalie always said, lies got but wee legs and don't run far. The documents belong to my employer. A deed to a townhouse in Vingerberg. And true enough, I've been drinking. I've been carried away. I lost them in a game of cards.
Then you whacked the winner on the head with a bottle.
What was it to do? He weren't willing to give him back. When the scoundrel drew a weapon, I fled. But without them papers, I haven't the gumption to show me face at home.
Here. Now pay up.
Of course I will. Give you all I've left. Wouldn't have it any other way.
Move it! Come on!
Siri was here. A spinning top. Gritka's toy. Siri must have used these. Looks like she left in a hurry. The Natural Obscurity of Curses by Lydia Van Bredevoort. Dedication to the Baron and his wife.
Get this.
Seems they had friends in high places in Vizima.
So you're Gretka?
I am. And you're Geralt.
How do you know?
Because you've white hair and a medallion shaped like a wolf. Siri told me about you.
You and Ciri talked a bit, didn't you?
We did.
Did she say where she was going, or what she came here to look for?
She said she was looking for you, and a sorceress. But you're here, so I guess she didn't find you. I wonder if she helped that friend of hers.
Ciri wanted to help a friend? Any idea who it was?
What do you mean, who? Her friend! She said he was in trouble and that she had to save him.
Look familiar?
My top! Where'd you find it?
Ciri's room.
We'd play in her room sometimes. I was sad one day, and Ciri carved it for me. Such a shame she had to leave.
Do you know where Ciri is?
No. One day I bought her breakfast, and she was already gone. The Baron told me she'd left.
Didn't ask where she'd gone?
I did. But he said I was too little and I wouldn't understand. But Ciri left me a gift.
A gift?
Yes, this. A green stone.
Beautiful as gifts go. Hide it well. Don't show it to anyone. It's worth a lot. Thanks, Gretka. Have fun.
But I'm not playing. I'm helping. Thistle. Thistle. Shenanaking.
Some hair of the hound. What have you got, Cap?
Move it!
Midges were biting on account of this downpour.
Got so fat.
Fancy a gap.
Show me. See ya. So long.
You!
An amulet.
What else you have?
Corpse teeth.
So long.
You ain't safe unless you got a gap.
Let me have a look at. So long.
Spot a shot.
Like to take. Farewell.
Thank you.
Greetings.
Wouldn't mind. Thanks. Farewell.
Lay me there, we're bound.
Bow them mines and took the wenches from Bellows too.
Excellent.
Come on.
Damn it.
save him, then dump him in a ditch! You're fucking dead!
Well, how long you gonna make me wait?
Interest you in a pass? Cheapest around, right here.
What kind of pass are we talking about?
You don't know. Redanians hold all the fords across the Pontar. Can't get through without a pass. But you're in luck. So happens I've got a few to sell.
What? Could dress up like Radovid and buy a gilded carriage for that much.
What am I to do if you can't afford it?
No deal.
Whoa, hold on. Might have a little work for you. Reduce the price for a job well done, eh?
What kind of work?
Nearby. Just to the southeast. My sister's husband's got a business. He and some lads tidy up battlefields. Problem is, there's always swarms of shite bothering them, you know, them monsters drawn to corpses. Give them some protection, and I'll swing you one beautiful discount.
All right.
Still sure you stole the goblets?
What do you want?
Hear about the notice. Got monster trouble?
Trouble? Good one. We're not having trouble. We're up shit fucking creek. Some shaggy fuck knows what sitting in the woods attacking every plough and transport that dares take the high road. We need out of bolts, arrows, rations, all around fucked. Sent a patrol out. Looks never came back. So the job's simple. Bring me the fucker's head, and I'll give you gold. As much as the notice says, I'm not gonna haggle. Quartermaster won't budge. But I can throw in a pass that'll get you across the Pontar. So, deal?
Sounds fair. See what I can do.
Master Witcher, there's an elven burial ground in the caverns near the ultimate pass. We'll deal with the witches.
Come on!
This be the witch.
Hey, yeah. look like claw marks. But here, an arrow. Shaft's broken off right at the skin. Clawed and gnawed. Necrophages fed here. But all the wounds they inflicted are post-mortem. Clawed and gnawed. Necrophages fed here. But all the wounds they inflicted are post-mortem. Looted bear. Either someone stole the cargo after the monster attack, or our monster collects military paraphernalia. Footprints. A survivor? Either that or the monster's a humanoid. Something's fishy here. I should follow these tracks. Might want to look around some.
One step more, and you'll gain a new hole in your head, Dwan. What do you seek here? Speak!
Oh, just out for a stroll. Getting some fresh air.
I hope you find yourself amusing, but I'm not laughing. Etme!
You're back, finally.
Did you get the beast?
No beast to speak of in the woods. Just elves from the Squire's hellband that attacked the convoys. Here, They're squirrel tails.
Scoia tell you, say? And I thought we'd exterminated the last of those vermin. And the non-humans left had wised up. Well, seems we'll need to pacify them again. Make a list of all the long ears around and hang every 10th one. That should do it.
Yeah, definitely.
I see we're of a mind on this. You're a good man. Here, the gold I promised you. And the pass. Good luck.
What do you say we join up?
Wouldn't mind a... Farewell.
Oh, you again.
All right.
Oh!
All are dry, like this.
Halt! No passage. Bridge is closed.
Because?
Because King Radovid said it should be. Won't let anyone through who don't have a pass.
Perfect. Just so happens I have a pass.
What?
Let me see. Doesn't seem forged. You never know. All right, move on.
That's it, Roach.
Mug went in the kitchen, stole a hunk of meat.
Cook gave him a licking, strung him by his feet.
Cook then bled him empty, stripped his skin off clean.
Laughed and said how tasty, best sausage I have seen.
Cook's a stupid killer, shouldn't have ate the pup.
Now we'll light a fire, gonna roast him up. 1, 2, 3, the one to fetch the kindlings, thee!
Interesting rhyme.
I don't know you. Go away.
I'm looking for the witches of Crookback Bog.
You look like a witch yourself. The witches of the bog. We can't go in the bog. Gran don't let us.
When my brother Zemek went missing, Gran said it was because he went in the woods and got lost. Gran cried an awful lot after that.
He could still come back.
What are you doing out here alone?
We's not alone. We's with Gran.
But where did you all come from?
We's orphans.
All of you?
There's a war, so there's orphans. Didn't know that.
A young woman got lost in the swamp. She has ashen hair and a scar on her face. You kids see anyone like that?
Ain't no lassies here.
What am I?
You're no lassie. Lassies got tits.
They do. I heard an old man say once, when the army was here, he says, hide them lassies in the woods. They's dazzling the soldiers with their tits. And it's torturing the poor lads. That's what he said.
Listen, the girl I'm looking for, she's in trouble. I understand you might not want to help me, but you could try to help her.
How you know she was here?
I heard she visited the witches in the swamp.
But there's no witches here.
There's only frogs.
And snakes.
And Johnny.
What's this talk? What kind of jabbering is this, eh? No one allowed here. Just kids. My kids. They're allowed. But who are you, wearing swords like a bandit?
You look after these kids?
They're my grandchildren.
Gran's good to us. Gonna be soup with scratchings for supper.
Kids get lost in the woods. I miss them. Seen them in the woods? No one has.
You one of the witches of the swamp? I hear Crookback Bog.
Witch? Me? Nay, I've no broom nor owl and not one wart on me nose. Got a pretty nose, see?
Gran's got a lovely beak.
Oh, you darling girl. Our kids are so sweet.
Who's Johnny?
Johnny ate a cat. Come the morn, some furry shat.
Watch your language! They tells tales and tales, naught but tales.
Just talking to the kids. Asked them if they'd seen a young woman.
I was a lovely young woman. Wore a long, beautiful braid my mummy did up for me. Had dresses with flowers on them.
Maybe you've seen her. Young, ashen hair.
Your betrothed?
Daughter, actually.
Daughter? My dear, sweet little daughter and her sister. Where are they now? Maybe they've come to some harm?
Had about enough of this. Asked a simple question. You seen the woman or haven't you?
Fear not, children.
There's nought to fear, Gran. He's only angry because he cares.
Maybe Johnny knows something. I'll take him to Johnny before he goes barmy on us.
Johnny's your invention, and you shouldn't be using those ugly words. To the hut. Go on now. You'll stand in the corner, I'll make sure you do. And you, stop scaring the little ones. Now go. Be gone. Can't come in here. Not allowed in here.
I just want to talk to the boy.
Not allowed. It's not allowed.
He won't talk to you anyway. Gran don't like you. And Johnny's made up. And stranger still, kids.
Just tell me where I can find Johnny.
Johnny's made up.
Be gone. Be gone.
Why don't you want to talk about Johnny? One of you knows about him. The others must too.
It's just him who's pals with Johnny. They pick mushrooms and hunt snails. But Gran says Johnny's made up.
Have any of you ever seen Johnny?
Of course. Looks just like him.
Then why do you say he's made up?
Gran says so. And Gran knows lots.
Does your Gran treat you right? She ever hurt you?
Never.
When we're bad, she cries.
She's scared. Says strangers might take us. And we'll disappear.
The boy who plays with Johnny, he must be brave.
Not brave, just stupid.
Sat his bare bum on an anthill once. But yeah, he plays with Johnny. He don't listen to Gran and goes in the woods, and then he's got to have a time out.
And he eats snails. Yuck.
The girl I mentioned is in danger. You gotta help me get your Gran away from the hut so I can talk to Johnny's friend.
All right, but you gotta do something for us too. Play hide and seek. Gran never does. Says her feet hurt.
Is there something else you need or want?
Oh, I want something sweet.
And me too.
Oh, fruits.
Give us a treat and we'll help you.
Here's some treats.
Yum.
Never eaten nothing like this before in my life.
Don't be afraid.
Don't know nothing.
I won't hurt you.
Where's Gran?
She's busy. Why are you scared to talk?
I'm not scared of nothing.
You're all scared of something. Would have told me about Johnny otherwise.
I'm worried about Johnny. He don't come around no more. Once, when we was mushroom picking, I saw his burrow. But Gran yelled at me. Said not to talk to strangers, because then kids go missing. She worries about Johnny too, though she says he's made up.
Where are you and your friend's parents?
Dead. Some starved. Others were killed. Like mine. One day, I went out at dawn to look for berries in the woods. Still some around back then. When I was coming home, I heard the yells, then laughing. Went up and hid in the bushes near the woods. My mum yelled, and the soldiers laughed. Lay my paw down by the barn door. His head clean off. And then my mom.
It's all right. That's enough. I just want to talk to Johnny. He could know more than you.
Not gonna hurt him, right? Because he's real. He's not made up.
I'm not gonna hurt him.
Johnny used to be boy, because Gran liked listening to his songs. When we was picking mushrooms, Johnny said he saw a girl with ashen hair in the swamp.
Where can I find Johnny?
There's a little meadow on the edge of the swamp. This strange tree grows there. Look around. You'll see him.
Thank you.
What are you on about? Who said ask, eh? Ugly word, ugly.
Footprint. Johnny's been through here. Lead to a burrow. Wonder what's inside.
Johnny? Don't be afraid.
You're a bucka? A Luton? Ah, a godling. Not many of you left. I'm looking for a woman with ashen hair. Seen her? Tell me everything, from the start. Where did you see her? What was she doing? It's important to me. Why not? What's wrong? Can't talk? Why? Lost your voice? Can I help you somehow? Want me to follow you? No choice, I guess.
Watch out!
close to me. This the place? Let me look around. Something's on the ledge? Something that'll get you your voice back? Guess I gotta make this climb. This bottle.
A pack of pickled peppers by the Pontar.
Done celebrating?
My favorite words! Life without savoring the sound of surreptitious shenanigans is like licking snails through a cloth. Thank you for this, noble whoever you are. Long be your life.
Hang on a minute. I helped you, now you help me.
Would you turn this beautiful act of altruism into a banal bartering of favors?
How'd you lose your voice?
One morning I awoke and opened my mouth for my usual bout of singing with the thrushes. Lo and behold, no sound escaped. I tried and tried, almost burst a blood vessel. Then I went to the village, because word has it, the new cunning woman works miracles. But people began crying out, "A smudger! A smudger!" and sick their dogs on me. Do I look like a smudger to you?
Not a bit.
Well, I thought not. So it must be the crone's doing. Who else would curse me? Blackbird friend of mine located my voice, but I was helpless to retrieve it.
Couldn't ask a raven friend to just give you the bottle?
Ravens serve the crones. They don't help no one.
I'm looking for a young, ashen-haired woman. See anyone like that?
Did I ever? Remember it as if it were yesterday. Soon as I woke, I went to empty my bowels. My favorite part of the day. Defecating to the sunrise. Downright glorious. Suddenly, heard a bang. So loud, it couldn't have been me. And that lass appeared. Out of nowhere. Young, ashen-haired. Just like you said. Wounded and panting to boot. She raced off towards the children's hut. Quick as if the crones were after her. I yelled some unpleasantries. She disturbed my mourn. Sadly, I'd lost my voice, so I don't think she heard me.
I've been to the village in the swamp, met a woman who might have been a crone.
Did she seem confused to you?
Nuts, completely.
So I'm not crazy. That's no crone. That's the granny who takes care of the orphans. Claims the kids made me up. Me!
An orphanage in a swamp?
What do you have against swamps? Lived here my whole life, and I heartily recommend it.
What do you know about the crones?
They're as old as this forest. Cruel. Vindictive. Not to be crossed.
What if someone does cross them?
Might take his voice. Might take his life. Depends on their whim. They're nasty. Although, they care for this land and its folk in their own way. Supposedly, they always keep their word. You must be careful what you ask for. Won't find them until they want to be found. See them until they want to be seen. But remember, they see and hear all that happens in the mire.
She ran off toward the orphanage. Kids could know something. Or the old woman who takes care of them.
Oh, that old hag don't speak to strangers, and you're a stranger.
Will she talk to you?
I have spoken to her, got my ways. So be it. You helped me, and I'm no bore. Come with me.
Damn, you're ugly.
It's clear, not a crone in sight. I need to sing to Gran. That ought to calm her.
Little Johnny softly gazed, fire waning pale. Pop! A spark jumped out and whispered, "Listen, I'm a tale."
You got your voice back.
I did. Though I seem to have lost an octave somewhere in the process. I shall look for it when I get home.
You're not allowed here, Johnny. You shouldn't have come.
Calm down, Gran. Don't get angry. It's not good for you.
The woman I asked about earlier.
Forgive me, Gran, but this fellow absolutely must talk to the ladies.
No, she's not allowed.
Please, it's important.
The fellow will be quiet. Gran, please hear me out. I found little Yagna when she got lost, did I not? Did I break Ginny's fever too? I did. I ask anything in return? No. Didn't even fuss about my stolen voice. Well, now I want something. Gran, help this fellow. Because otherwise he'll pester me day and night, even during potty time. His lass is missing. Perhaps the ladies can help find her, eh?
Well, since you put it that way, Johnny, I'll help him. Come with me. Johnny's a good, good lad. Though the ladies don't like him. No. Foul creature, they say. Don't like him.
Who are the women in the tapestry?
Those are the ladies. Ladies lovely, with power o'er all, beseech I thee, answer my call. Before you a worm crawls, wretched and small.
How dare you disturb our rest, woman?
Looking for the woman with ashen hair. I know you met her. Where is she?
Oh, he's impatient. Perhaps he only likes ashen-haired girls.
It's clear you met her. Tell me everything.
That was blunt. Well, perhaps it's for the best. Tell me, have you got bollocks? Do you fear woodland beasts?
Oh, hard times are upon this white-haired one. Brother has turned against brother. The land is soaked in blood. Evil reigns stronger than ever before.
A dark power has surfaced near Dunwarren. It feeds on hatred and disdain. Destroy the beast, and we will be grateful. Tell you all we know about this ashen-haired maid.
Dark power? You need a knight-errant, or a witch-hunter, not a witcher.
The alderman of Dunwarren will tell you all. Remember to collect payment from him after you complete your task. And now our servant will bring you the dagger.
Dagger? What for?
When the alderman sees this dagger, he'll know we sent you. He'll aid with all.
I'll talk to the alderman, but I can't promise anything.
Move, woman! Give the young man the dagger.
And you, white one, return only once you've completed the task.
Aye, mistress, right. On me way. Dagger. Gotta bring the dagger. The dagger. For you. Ladies told me to give it you. Here it is. The dagger. place the Alderman's payment on the stone. Stone Bear, Stone Shear, Stone Nose, Stone Ears.
Greetings. Nice village.
Aye.
A real pearl of the swamps.
If you say so.
You get by all right?
Aye, winter to winter. Somehow we survive.
Recognize this dagger?
Aye, master. I didn't know you belonged to them.
Don't belong to anyone. Down to business. I want to get this done quickly.
Ah, so that's how it's to be.
I'm supposed to help solve your problem. Tell me what it is. Just the essentials.
The war awoke an ancient power. An evil one that feeds on bloodshed. Nightmares haunt our nights and days. Folks sleepwalk from their homes, never to return. Under the tree on the Whispering Hillock they lie. Unburied all. Fathers, sons, daughters, and mothers. Folk are afeard to move them. You must go there. The dark powers must be cast off.
Need more details.
You must see for yourself. Me grand's mum whacked me crosswise for straying near the Whispering Hillock. But what happens there now is a wonder.
A few times folk from round here gather to chop down the trees and burn the cursed soil back to use. None returned. The ground beneath the weeds is white with human bones.
When did all this start?
3 years back. I remember, 'twas a warm day. Went to check the snares for game. Pulled a hare from me trap. It grew dark all of a sudden, though it was nigh on noontime. Thought it was a storm at first. A squeal pierced the air, near burst me ears. The hair rotted in me hands, and the leaves shriveled and yellowed, though it were yet the start of summer. Times have been ill ever since. Folks' teeth turn black as charcoal. Women folk fight like polecats, bawling and brawling over nothing. The young'uns, born crippled, lame, fear and cursing. Long have we pled for the lady's help.
Ladies of the Wood don't know what this power is?
They know all. Old Thekla claimed they'd be punishing us. Folks stop respecting them. Some even call them witches. But must not be they, for they sent you.
I'll look around the Whispering Hillock.
You be careful, Master Witcher. Don't ye treat this evil light.
Roach.
faster. Place of power. Should draw from it. Kid.
Egon! Come no closer. I know whence you come. The powers that protect me, they sense whence you come. My freedom, your wish.
I was attacked.
This is my prison. A fortress besieged. Murdered. murder as I await, and my forest protects me.
Murderers?
Murderous sisters. Killed my body. Now my soul they hunt, for I defy them.
I saw women, children, lying dead on this hill. Did they want to destroy you?
To nature. To the forest and earth. All death is alive. Every death is full. I cry. I wail. None listen.
Who are you?
I abandoned my circle, where I kept the balance. The crones killed me and cursed my ghost.
Never heard of a druid circle in Valen.
I wander eternally through a maze of vows, helplessly sliding or rusting. Velen's curse. They year all through severed ears. They weave hair and twist lines. They take their strength from the broth of human flesh.
Why did they kill you?
The crones want this land. They'd rule the wood alone. I stood in their way.
Prison. How so?
I am bound here, in fetters of magic. I wander endlessly, along the waves. The children, I know all. I know what awaits them. Free me, please. I must help.
If something threatens the orphans, I'll help them myself.
The children have been taken. Free me, please. I come near Gale, a gallop unchained. I shall save them. Only I can.
Why do you think the kids from the meadow are in danger?
The sisters took them. They shall not return.
Where'd they take them? I can help.
It is done already. It cannot be undone. There are no rules to art ceremony. They shall all die. Let them be saved.
The crones. What do you know about them?
The sisters are older than the oldest trees. Velen is their realm. All life here serves them. The sisters live concealed. You will not find them. They hear all. You cannot hide.
If you can save the orphans from the meadow, I'll help you.
I will find them. Free them. Open the door of my cage. Blood is my escape. A rite you must perform. With the black of raven feathers, the white of my bones, and the swift steed, the mare wild and free, in meadows pasture cold, dark as a bottomless well, black as the depths of night. Such a beast, no other. Gather these and bring them here. Find my remains, and bring me a mount.
A wind-born steed, a black squall-turned horse.
Why do we need a black horse?
The beast and I shall be as one. As when I lived, we shall be a gale. Nothing to stop us. A wild steed from meadows moist.
Where'll I find your remains?
My bones. They lie in a solitary mound nearby, due west.
I'll gather what I need to free you, then return.
Gather and return to the Ilamuk's depths, to the tree's rotten heart. Pierce my heart. Let blood flow to be born again. I must first be consumed.
Go now and return through the passage I have opened.
Let's go! Faster.
Thank you.
bodies of women and children in the woods. You've killed people who are no threat to you.
The wood killed them, for nature is blind. Death is never more than death.
I offer raven feathers.
Once I was free, I shall be free once more.
I offer your remains.
Once I was flesh, I shall be flesh once more.
Solved your problem. Just in case, though, avoid the Whispering Hillock for a while.
Cannot be. Where's something lurking there?
An evil spirit had possessed a tree on the hill. It was responsible for the killings.
How'd ye dispel this evil?
Went up the hill, took care of the problem. The details are my concern.
Aye, truly said. I knows naught of such things anyway.
The crones, or the ladies of the wood as you call them, said to remind you about payment. Take it you know what they want?
Aye, I do. Give me the dagger. Be back soon.
Payment. Take it to the ladies, will you?
What the hell was that?
'Tis our pact. You're a stranger. You don't know life here. It's honest pay for their protection.
So, all those ears in the woods?
Put it out your mind, master. You soon be leaving and we must tarry on our young'uns and their young'uns after them. No gods nor masters watch over Velen. The land is no man's. He who wants to survive must seek his own protectors.
Weapon, young man.
In real life, you're different than you were in the tapestry.
Well, bring it here. Once more.
We are forgiving creatures, but you allowed the children to escape.
They never wanted to flee. They liked it here. They played.
Your punishment must be harsh. Now silence! We must speak to the white-haired one.
I know that mark. This is Anna, the wife of the Baron of Crow's Perch.
She belongs to no man.
A fruit ripened in her womb. A fruit sprouted from seed sown by a man she detested.
We helped her. She agreed to serve. She bears the mark. She is ours. Come. It is another woman who interests you. Speak, white-haired one.
You used me to tame the Whispering Hillock. A lot of work.
Not free, brave soul.
Did you destroy the evil powers? Have you brought peace to our domain?
I freed the spirit trapped in the tree.
Hear that, sisters?
Traitor!
She took the children! Twas her!
We made a deal. I was supposed to help the villagers. I held up my end of the bargain. They're safe now.
So, a mockery you chose to outwit.
Whose spirit was trapped in the tree?
That of one who once cheated death. You freed an ancient power.
It will rise again. Elsewhere, beyond our reach, blood will flow once more.
What foolish things men sometimes do!
You looked different in the tapestry.
We're all dressed up just for you.
If you only knew how much time we spent in front of the glass.
Do you desire us?
I'm impressed. Polymorphism, a rare talent.
Oh, I'd suck every last drop out of you.
Ah, to be woven together with you? I'd be your best and last.
Not what I came for. Our deal. I did my part, now you do yours.
A word once given, we never break.
The girl. Mousy blonde. That's what they call it.
Thin as a rail. Terrified. Exhausted. She could barely stun the poor thing.
We cared for her as best we could.
Like she was our own daughter.
Wasted affection. She proved a very naughty girl.
Mischievous, stubborn, and selfish.
The young woman I seek never hurt anyone without cause.
You've not seen her long. She's changed for the worse.
Why'd she attack you?
She's no longer the girl you once knew. Wrath consumes her.
Don't believe you. They say you always keep your word. So tell me everything, exactly as it happened.
We shall tell you, brave boy. We knew someone special was alive. We read beast entrails, saw the omens.
We would glimpse her likeness. A mirage in a puddle. She came from the lower swamp.
We knew not at first it was her the omens had spoken of.
A child of the elder blood. The soul seed that would burst into flame.
She fell into our hands. Elder blood!
The blood of the traitress. Does she sleep?
Like a lamb.
Come, sisters, no point in dawdling. The table's set. The cauldron bubbles.
We cannot. You know she is meant for him.
Imlareth will get her. He will. But not whole.
Well said. We'll just have a sample.
I'll take her feet. Lovely. Mm-hmm. Plump. Perfect for a broth.
I can taste it already. Very well. Get on with it! Oh, you'll regret that, girl. Regret it dearly.
Tried to kill her. Tried to butcher her like an animal and eat her.
Her blood. The taste brought back memories of our youth.
Elder blood. Extraordinary girl. But you know that. Such a shame she fled.
You tried to kill her. Can't forgive you for that.
Waste of words. Our fates are bound true. But now is not the time for that to bear fruit.
Now you shall chase shadows and wander midst fog.
Each time you see her, she will be a mirage. And if you find her, if the girl will die,
I'll see you,
handsome knight.
Baron Schmarin, if I want to plough some peasant lass, I will.
I'm listening. What do you come to me with?
Got news of your wife.
Ploughing hell, why'd you not say so forthwith? Where is she? Why have you not returned with her?
She's in Crookback Bog. Got food, a place to live, and keeps herself busy. Didn't look like she had the slightest desire to leave.
You were to bring her back, not report on the condition she lives under!
I was supposed to find her, and I did. That was our deal, nothing more.
You still think me rotten to the core. A base bastard, don't you? You believe I alone am at fault for what happened here?
Doesn't matter what I believe.
Yet, looking at you, I see contempt. Can't speak for the world you witches inhabit. But in ours, nothing is ever black and white.
Probably gonna say you're not the only one to blame. All right then, I'm willing to hear your side of the story.
With Annie, it was love at first sight. A spear tore through my shoulder at the Battle of Ankur. She tended to my wound. Once I'd recovered, I asked her to marry me. She wept with joy. Soon after, Tamara was born. And after that, they sent me to Sidaris. A warlord had risen against King Ethan, and Faltest sent help. It was one battle to the next. One conflict after another. It was a life of war. I was seldom home, and I found comfort in drink. Grew so fond of hooch, I couldn't part with it when I did get home.
All right. What then?
I went from front to front, battle to battle, collecting soldiers' coin, while Anna sat alone with the babe for months. Later, I learned she'd not been so alone after all. For nearly 3 years, she'd found comfort in the arms of one Evan, a childhood friend, a dog's bunghole. Understand, dammit? One tussle in the hay I'd have waved aside, put it out of my mind. But the woman cuckolded me for years, without a whisker of concern for me, for my love.
How'd you find out?
Came home one day and Anna was gone. The things too. Found a letter. She wrote that she didn't love me. That she'd left me for that knob licker and taken Tamara with her. Felt like I'd been rammed in the arse by a horse. I went to find the bugger, to get the girls back, bring them home. Yet soon as I saw him, something turned inside me, something dark. I slaughtered the shit-eating twat and fed his carcass to the dogs.
Guess they call you the Bloody Baron for a reason after all.
What?
Your nickname makes sense now.
No, no, that's an entirely different story.
Imagine Anna wasn't exactly pleased.
Ha! Bloody understatement if I've ever heard one. She flew into a fit, hysteria, threw herself at me, kicking and clawing. Finally grabbed a knife. It would have been the end of me if I'd not leapt aside. It was the first time I hit her. I had to calm her. Felt I had no other means. Things changed. They would never be the same. Anna tried to take her own life, and mine, several times. She would prod me, goad me, taunt me, in the hope I would hit her again, perhaps. She'd scream that I'd robbed her a life of love, that I'd destroyed the idea for her, and so might as well kill her. How many times I apologized. How many armfuls of blooms and gifts I brought. She cared not a bit. 2 years of her anger had turned to indifference, broken at times by her bouts of hysteria and my bouts of drunkenness. Cannot fathom how we survived those years, but we did. Though as you know now, not everything was as it might have seemed.
You're right. Faults on both sides, yours and hers.
I'm content that you finally see that. Very well then. If you won't bring Anna home, you might at least tell me how she landed in that blasted swamp.
She made a pact with the crones and... well, I think she might have lost her mind.
A pact? What the bloody hell?
She was with child. A child she didn't want to bear. Went to the crones for help. They promised to rid her of the problem in exchange for a year of her service. And they kept their word, in their own twisted way.
What do you mean?
Anna must have thought the child inside her would somehow disappear. Instead, the crones sapped her of strength, and ultimately forced her body to miscarry. I think that's when she started to lose her mind. Then they placed magic tethers on her. Tethers that cause great pain when tested. A guarantee she'll pay off her debt.
A pact with witches? Bloody nightmare, sounds like some jest. We must get her out. We can't leave her there.
Venturing into the swamp, even with armed men, is just a bad idea. It's a dangerous place inherently. And I think those crones are a greater threat than anyone realizes.
I'll not sit on my ass waiting for them to return her. Would you wait? Count on their mercy if they had your daughter?
Probably not, but I'm a witcher.
And I'm a husband and a father who's fucked up his life and the lives of his loved ones. I'll gather my men, go there and retrieve Anna.
We had a deal. I've done my part. Your turn to do yours.
A word once given. Now what did I last?
Basilisk. It had just attacked you.
Ah, right. Gargantuan. One solid brute. I thought we breathed our last.
Watch out!
If I don't survive this, you're to take whatever you want from the fortress.
You'll survive!
Let's show this bastard what we're worth! You have everything?
Yes, thank you.
What you did for me, I shall never forget it.
You helped me as well. When your man brought me here, you fed me, cared for me, had my wounds looked after. We're even now.
You needn't leave. You're in good company here. We'll always have a warm corner for you.
I must leave. Wraiths pursue me. The Wild Hunt. I was foolish to use the power. They're sure to have caught my scent.
The Wild Hunt? Pursuing you?
I'll endanger all of you by remaining here. You must tell the people to bar their doors and windows. And no one is to wander the night.
And you? Where do you think you're going?
Now, I ride for Novigrad. And then, who knows where.
She mounted and rode off. It grew awfully empty without her.
So there's a chance Ciri's still in Novigrad. Thanks for helping her.
It's nothing. Now you've learned what you wanted to know, you must be in a hurry. But if you could...
Spit it out.
I want to go get Anna. Free her. Bring her back. I don't believe she's there willingly.
Must have not heard me. Any journey into the swamp is suicide.
I heard you. Which is why I could use your aid. I've no more tales of Ciri to offer you. But go with me and I'll be generous with what I do have. Very generous.
Extra coin never hurt.
Ha! True indeed. I'll round up my men and ride to Down Warren. You can join us there.
Fine. Sounds good.
Dare you! Stand here!
Sorry, we was there.
What was that?
You tell me. Man or monster? My men call him Uma and say he's a beast. But he seems a man to me. Just hideous as Ardle's shit.
Doesn't look like a monster, but my medallion's trembling. Strange. Where'd you find him?
Funny story, actually. I won him in a game of cards.
Funny story? How so?
Went to Novigrad once, to rest, indulge in the city's pleasures. Stayed at a tavern, and some folk there were playing, so I joined in. Cards were kind that day. Had one devilish hand after another. Robbed the horsons blind. One fellow, a merchant, took it especially hard. He'd gambled away everything he'd brought from Skellige. Wanted terribly to play another hand, so I agreed. Asked him what he had to wager, and he showed me that sideshow. Not much in it for me, but fuck it, I thought. I'll give the man a chance to win something back. Luck was not with him, and Uma wound up here at Crow's Perch. End of story.
Proper baron now. Even got a jester.
Aye. Though I feel something's not right with him.
How so?
Well, he seems more beast than man. But there's wisdom, cunning in the bastard's eyes. Or maybe I'm imagining it. Ever run into anything like him?
No. But he doesn't look dangerous.
I guess that's that. Doesn't eat much, so as long as he's no trouble, the boys might as well have some diversion.
Time I was on my way. So long.
Farewell. I hope you find your daughter. And prove a good father to her.
Hey, yeah. That's him.
fast, Roach.
Meet the Smiths, lads. Get toothed one.
Got a bad idea. Nice tip.
I'm talking about the Shrieker, wreaking havoc in the peasants' coops now.
You fancy your man well travelled, so tell me.
Beat me, Wick.
Oh, lifeless, move it!
That seems past
my quite the work my man's got, eh?
Not half bad.
Their arses whipped like a Novi Rad whore!
Thank you.
rats, why did he need them?
Kira, what are you doing?
Geralt! You gave me quite a start.
But nay, the magi says bring me rats and healthy ones. Not something the cat dragged in.
This the lamp from the elf's hideout? And what's this about rats?
Nothing important. I'll explain later. Now tell me, to what do I owe the pleasure?
Mentioned you wanted something from me.
I did, and still do. The cursed isle on Lake Windamma, you've heard of it, I'm sure. The local peasants mumble incessantly about it, about the wraiths that haunt it. They claim none who go there return.
How'd it come to be cursed?
That's what I don't know. I must break this spell, yet I've been unable to identify its source.
Gotta know something.
Scraps. The curse is somehow linked to the tower where Serard, the lord of these lands, took refuge when Nilfgaard invaded. Claims in the village are that peasants, desperate of hunger, sailed to Fyke Isle to beg for food. Met their end there. It was a massacre. So, will you please help me lift this curse? You're so good at these things.
All right, I'll help.
I knew you'd find it irresistible. Naturally, you'll need to sail to Fyke Isle.
Fine. What then?
Well, the spirits who wander the isle, you must establish a rapport with them. Don't know how, but they could point us in the direction of the curse's source.
Think they'll be willing to chat?
Of course, provided you take my magic lamp with you. I shall let you keep it afterwards in appreciation. You'll find it quite useful, I'm sure.
Can't you just come with me?
I tried to go to Fyke Isle once. Thought my head would burst, the curse's magic was so strong.
Nice of you to send me there.
I experienced an acute nasal hemorrhage. You stand to endure a wobble of your medallion at most. At Aretusa, they trained me to detect even the subtlest magic pulses. This was like getting smacked across my haunches with a grain flail.
Funny. Thought you'd go in for that sort of thing.
Take my boat. I left it on the lake shore near the village. Should be fit to use. Provided rot hasn't eaten it, as it seems to eat everything here.
How's the lamp actually work? I mean, do I just rub it, or do I have to do something, magical?
You needn't even rub. Just place it where you find bones and hear whispers. I suppose I should warn you. It might not be the most pleasant experience.
Figured as much. Tell you all about it later. Maybe skip the drastic bits.
You'll need to do neither. I'll give you a Xenovox. It's a bauble that will let us speak over some distance. You will tell me what you see, and I shall tell you what to do and look for.
I need to know anything else before I go?
No, that is all. Oh, go already. I can't wait to see what you discover on Fyke Isle. Just be sure to come and see me afterwards. And... Geralt.
Hmm?
Thank you.
Thank you. Geralt and Yennefer were reunited, but something even more important happened in Vizima. Geralt learned that Cirilla, his one-time ward, had returned from afar, and she was in danger. He was to find her, at the Emperor's command and Yennefer's behest.
Evain Kershaw, is Daithwin Hound incarnate mortal?
Wouldn't mind a few rounds of cards.
Wounded and tired, Ciri collapsed in the swamp. Some peasants found her and took her to the Baron, Velen's self-appointed ruler. The warlord took the young woman in, had her nursed back to health, then sent her on her way to Novigrad.
What was that about?
What's become of me in me elder years? Refused a roof over me head by a common churl. I was born a noble's daughter. My brother and I, we managed the manor for years.
What happened to him?
A caller came one day. A drifter, a hunter. It wasn't long before we fell in love and wed. We prepared to leave the manor. My brother, he took offense, refused to bid me farewell. Years on I returned, but found no sign of him. Folk claimed monsters had infested our home, come to nest there.
I could take care of those monsters for you.
You're a witcher, right? No ordinary man would be so eager. Don't fret. It's all the same to me, provided you're honest. The house is east of here. Take this key. Once you've driven off the beasts, look for a chest. My treasure. Savings, really. They're yours.
What'll that leave you with?
A roof over my head is all I need. And if it comes to it, I've other heirlooms to sell. But I know you witchers don't work for free. I could never let you go without honest pay. Gods keep you.
Greetings!
Farewell.